Last night, I was reading and thinking about the impacts of quantum teleportation on teleporting and consciousness and things. And this morning, CGP Grey just released a video about teleportation and consciousness. So I just couldn't resist really, really quickly writing up a very quick response video. Sometimes I spend like days and months working on scripts. This script, I literally sat down and wrote in about 30 minutes, so it may suck. It's a situation where like I already was thinking about this stuff, so it's easy when I have a clear direction of what I'm trying to say and what I'm trying to do, of how to actually be able to write the script. So now I'm gonna record it, and then I'll do some drawing and some other stuff.
My good friend CGP Grey has made a great video about the practical and philosophical concerns.
I have now finished editing the audio, and I have the storyboard all drawn. It is right here. This fancy storyboard. And now what I'm doing is I'm going to do the drawings. Alright, so now the first drawing, and this one actually isn't a drawing, it's the some shots from Gray's video. So then the second drawing here is this narration.
In particular, the concern that when a transporter dismantles the atoms in your body and reassembles an identical arrangement of atoms somewhere else, perhaps the disassembled you actually dies, and the reassembled you is actually a new being that just thinks it's you. And if they simply hadn't...
One additional thing I think about when I'm drawing is I try to draw things from left to right so that my hand reveals the picture. Alright, so there's one drawing. The first drawing of the video. It is done now. On to do the rest of the video. I finished the drawings for the video. I've come back after dinner and I'm gonna edit it together. My drawings are actually image sequences. I take pictures, as you could tell by the loud noise of the camera. It's upside down because the camera is upside down, so what I have to do is turn them up right side up and color correct it and stuff. And then it looks better.
In particular, the concern that when a transporter dismantles the atoms in your body and reassembles an identical arrangement of atoms somewhere else, perhaps the disassembled you actually dies.
Okay, so I actually need to add in a visual effect here for when the disassembled person dies. I want a little ghosty figure to leave. And that's obviously not something I can do on paper. So what I'm trying to do is make this guy have kind of a little ghosty version of himself that leaves. So I've separated out on a separate layer just the guy from that. And what I'm going to do is animate it, moving over a series of frames, you know, somewhere up into the sky. And what that's going to do is, over time, it's going to move up there. And then obviously I don't want it to be that opaque, so I'll make him a little bit fainter. Then I'm going to have that fade out over time as well. So by somewhere like here, it's going to be around zero. Just kind of playing around with things. I've got the visual effect done, so here's what it looks like.
Perhaps the disassembled you actually dies, and the reassembled you is actually a new being that just thinks it's you.
Not that complicated. I really like doing visual effects when they're used carefully and tastefully, and not just to be fancy. I'm at the exciting stage where I have finished the video, and I'm exporting it. Here we go. I just experienced one of the great joys of making videos. Which is exporting the video and having it export all the way to the very end, and at the very last minute, it fails due to an unknown compiler error. So, I am trying to re-export it and we'll see what happens. When I'm trying to decide on a thumbnail, I will just look through the video and try to find what I think is going to look like a good thumbnail. And normally they kind of jump out and are pretty obvious, so I think this one with the teleportation in it may be one of the more compelling ones. I ended up going with a thumbnail that was a little bit more customized. I took pieces of two of the teleportation ones and added this arrow in the middle. And then I also have a version of it that has a title. This is Quantum Teleportation. Hopefully those are more compelling thumbnails and people will want to click on them.
You may have noticed this is a bit of an unusual video, not my normal style, and I'd like to thank you for watching it. This video was sponsored by Audible.com. As you know, Audible is one of the leading providers of audiobooks, and they have a special offer code just for this video to see whether or not people want to watch more Minute Physics behind the scenes. So if you go to audible.com/behindthephysics, you can get a free 30-day trial of Audible. And for a book, I'd like to recommend Creativity, Inc. by Ed Catmull. It's about the history of Pixar, why they're so consistent at making successful movies, and the challenges that they faced growing a creative company. Ed Catmull's insights have actually been super helpful for me putting together and organizing the team that now makes the sister channel of Minute Physics, Minute Earth. So again, thank you to Audible for supporting this behind-the-scenes video with a free trial at audible.com/behindthephysics. It'll let them know that you came from this video in particular, and maybe they'll sponsor more behind-the-scenes videos in the future. Thanks for watching.